हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे वी हैव सीन द केस ऑफ सिंपल पेंडुलम विच इज बेस्ड ऑन द सिंपल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेशंस एंड देयर वी हैव सीन दैट हाउ कैन वी मेक ऑसिलेशंस इन अ सिंपल पेंडुलम. मीन्स व्हाट आर द कंडीशंस टू गेट द सिंपल हार्मोनिक मोशन. लाइक वी हैव द कंडीशन थ्रेड शुड बी वेटलेस, थ्रेड शुड बी एक्सटेंस inextensible, thread should be flexible and also the mass or bob which we are using that should be point massive and heavy. So using such types of conditions it is possible to get the simple harmonic oscillations in our daily life also. So for that purpose we use a heavy spherical ball that is known as bob and in place of any string we use a cotton thread for the purpose of that. So that serves nearly the purpose of simple pendulum. So that's why we can get nearly simple harmonic oscillations with the help of simple pendulum. So this is very simple device that based on its working is based on the process of simple harmonic motion. And in this factor we have discussed the time period of the oscillations. And one thing actually I just want to correct here. As we have omega is equal to root k by m. So here this k is the spring factor. And this m is inertia factor. So as we discussed yesterday that in case of simple pendulum, as you are see, you have seen that there is angular motion, rotational motion. So due to that types of motion, the angle formed at the point of suspension means there will be angular motion, and due to angular motion, you know that there will be the concept of inertia that will arise, and the concept of inertia in case of angular motion that is analogous to the mass of the as in mass in the linear motion. Clear? So that's why in place of m in case of simple pendulum we can say that here this is inertia factor, and k is already you know that this is due to spring, so we can call it spring factor. But now if we want to calculate frequency of the oscillation, then you know that this angular frequency omega is given by 2 pi nu, and that is equal to k by m or spring factor upon inertia factor. And with the help of it we can calculate what is the value of frequency here, that is equal to in terms of, let's write spring factor upon inertia factor. Clear? So this is the frequency of the oscillation. Means with if we know the spring factor and inertia factor, then we can calculate it. And already we have calculated spring factor and inertia factor in case of simple pendulum. So the spring factor in this case that is equal to mgL. Okay? And also inertia factor we have calculated. So that is equal to ml square. Okay? Now let's put its value here. So nu is equal to, that is obtained 1 upon 2 pi spring factor, let's put it here mgl, and inertia factor ml square. So finally what we get, this is 2 pi root g by l. So this is the frequency of the oscillation. Actually this is not the time period of the oscillation. This is frequency of the oscillation which we get in case of simple pendulum. Means any simple pendulum that will oscillate simple harmonically, that will have a frequency, natural frequency, that will be equal to this factor. Means this frequency is depending on two factors. Now one is G and second is L. Means on changing the length, frequency of the oscillation that will increase or decrease, and on changing G that will increase or decrease. So it's very simple that where G is maximum, their frequency will be maximum, and where G is decreasing, like at hills or in mines, G is decreasing, then in that case this frequency of simple pendulum that will also decrease, means number of oscillations that will decrease per second, okay? And if we increase the length continuously, then due to increase in length, oscillations will be bigger, and in that case number of oscillations will reduce. So that's why with increase in length also frequency of the vibration that is reduces. So then in the, on these both factors, frequency of the simple pendulum that depends on. So now I think today we have discussed what is the frequency of the oscillation and on which factor it is dependent on. So let's see its time period, and also with the help of time period, let's see the dependency of time periods on different factors. So as we have nu equal to 1 upon 2 pi, that is equal to a spring factor upon inertia factor. So as you know that the time period is reciprocal of frequency, so we can calculate easily from here. The value will be here 2 pi inertia factor upon a spring factor. So if you solve after putting inertia factor and spring factor, or simple with the help of this formula we can solve it. So if you solve this in the reciprocal form, then we get 2 pi root L by G. So this is the time period of the simple pendulum, and with the help of it we can easily calculate what will be the time period. Means if suppose that we know the gravity, acceleration due to gravity where we are performing the experiment, and also the thread, we can measure it, length of the thread. So with the help of that we can easily calculate what will be the value of time period for that simple pendulum. Now let's see one by one what is the factors that can affect it. So the time, you have the formula of time period. Let's write it again. This is t equal to 2 pi root L by G. Okay? So first factor that will affect it, that is its length. So as we are seeing that t is directly proportional to root L. So it means that when t will increase, then time period will increase, means it will take greater time to perform one oscillations. As we have seen that number of oscillations are decreasing, and that's why we can easily, means the time period is increasing, since it means that in one oscillation it will take more time to oscillate, clear? So that's why it directly dependent on this value. And also we can understand very easily that when L tend to infinity, then T will tend to infinite. So in this case, when time period is infinite, it means that when we displace it to from its equilibrium or mean position, then it will never return to its, means it means time period is infinite, since it will take infinite time to perform one oscillation. And we don't know what is the time, infinite time, and what means we cannot calculate it. So I'm just saying that if length of the wire that is increasing continuously, length of the thread that is increasing continuously, then the time period of the oscillation that will continue, and ultimately if it will tend to infinite, then time period also tend to infinite. It means that oscillations will not be there. So oscillation will stop in that case, clear? So that's why we have to make or simple, we have to take the thread of a certain length so that we can observe the oscillations in case of simple pendulum. The reason is, I think, clear from here. Next case is, if we see the dependency of time period on G, so T is inversely proportional to root G. So if obviously g will increase, then due to that time period of the oscillation will decrease, and also if d will decrease, time period will increase. It means that if we go to the hills or in mines, then there you know that with height and depth, time gravity acceleration due to gravity, that is decreasing. So that's why at and means at that places, at hills or in mines, obviously time period of the oscillation, that will increase. And means if it is sufficiently in deep or at height, then definitely the clock will so the different times in this way, clear? Means the time period of the simple pendulum, or suppose that we are using any clock, and sorry, in any clock we are using the simple pendulum to so the ticking of it, then for that case obviously with use in simple pendulum, the time period, the time of the clock, that will change. So that's why we cannot use such types of materials for the for making the pendulum of any clock, clear? So or simple, if we will go to hills and in mines, then we have to change the watch at that time or clock that time. So due to this property, we always take such types of material which cannot change with the help of means with this, but definitely it will change because it is depending on the gravity factor, and due to gravity, time period of the pendulum, that will obviously change. So that's why clock will show the different times when we are going to hills or in mines. So you can understand it very easily, then how can it be possible, clear? Means if you see that, if suppose that g is equal to 0, like g is 0 at center, then in that case t will tend to infinite. Means if continuously we go into the deep, continuously we are going to the depth and we reaches to the center of the earth, then at that point time period will increase continuously and finally it will tend to infinite. Again this case will occur, and in that case also oscillations will not be completed, and that's why simple harmonic oscillation will stop there. Okay, so at center there are no oscillations that can be obtained. The third factor on which this is depending on, that is temperature. So how the temperature is depending on, as you have already studied about the length expansion or simple expansions in solids, you have already studied about that. So as you know that when we provide heat to any solid, then there can be expansion in its length or in its volume or in its area. So depending on that, we had three types of expansion: linear expansion, areal expansion, volume expansion, and we have already discussed all that things the in previous chapters. So you can you know that obviously length is depending on this factor. Now that means temperature factor. Means if delta T is change in temperature, means temperature is changing, due to change in temperature, its length always increases. So if temperature, suppose that temperature is increasing, then in that case length will increase, and due to increase in length, you can see that easily, obviously if length will increase, its time period will change. So with the increase in temperature, there will be also change in time period of the simple pendulum. So if you perform experiments in different weathers, and also at the same time, same place, you are performing experiments in winters and in summer, so there is temperature difference in both cases. So in that case, time period of the oscillation, that will change at the same place. So don't be surprised for that, because it is there is process of linear expansion in threads that is taking place. So that's why we always try to make the pendulum, or we are trying to take the string of such types of material which show the minimum linear expansion to so that its time period will not be affected. So actually the why we are discussing these things will helps us to understand the factor that is affecting the time period, and with the help of that, if we are making any clock using any simple pendulum, then we have to think first that this factor will affect, then time period will change, means there will be no uniformity in time. So how can we use that clock? If it will change in winters, it will change in summer, then how can we use that? So that's why we need a material, such types of material which can not affected by such types of all things. So that's why we are discussing it here. With the help of it, we will be able to search such types of material, so that we have to know that first. So I think that is clear to you, the temperature factor. So with increase in temperature, there will be linear expansion, and with the linear expansion, there will be increase in length. And due to increase in length, obviously time period of the oscillation that will increase. Clear? The next factor which affected that is the case of density of the material. So as you know that due to change in density of the material, also length is also changing, and also gravity also changes. So if you see the case of gravity in case of length, then it obtained in such a way. So in the case when density of the material that is changing, then with change in density, the gravity that is decreasing. So that's why if gravity is decreasing, then easily we can say that length time period is increasing. Also you can understand the density effect with the help of linear expansion. So as we have seen that already, with change in density, there is expansion in solids that taking place. So if extension is taking place, then we can easily say that there is increase in time period. So these are the factors that are affecting the simple pendulum. Also a case that will you study, that is the second pendulum. So what is the second pendulum? Actually its name is given due to reason that its time period is 2 seconds. So if we can make such types of simple pendulum whose time period is 2 seconds, then that types of simple pendulum is known as second pendulum. So if for second period pendulum, let's put the time period 2 seconds, then we have t is equal to 2 pi root L by G. So here we can put 2 pi root L by G, or you can easily calculate what will be the value of L and G. That is L by G is equal to 1 upon pi square, or L equal to G upon pi square. So if we know the value of G already, 9.8, you can put it. And after putting it, we can solve at the surface. Actually, we can solve it easily. So after putting this value and the value of pi, we can solve it for the second pendulum. So this is obtained nearly equal to 98.33 centimeter. So it means that it is nearly equal to 1 meter. So if we take 1 meter string and a bob is attached to it, and we are slightly displacing it to its from its equilibrium position or mean position, then this pendulum will have the time period of 2 seconds always. So this is the case of simple second pendulum. So such types of pendulum is second pendulum, in which we have to take the length that is nearly equal to 1 meter. Clear? So this is the special case actually that is used to perform oscillations, and also used to see the effect of length on time period. Suppose that if we are changing the length here, we are not taking 1 meter, we are taking 95 centimeter or other things. Suppose that we are taking 105 centimeter, then in that case, obviously due to change in length, time period will change, and we can easily calculate it with the help of second pendulum. So this experimentally we used it to perform simple pendulum and also see the effect of simple pendulum. So as we see that a number of cases where we can calculate the time period, and we can also understand what factor can affect it. Some other factors, as I have told you, beside the factors that can affect, that is, suppose that this simple pendulum is mounted on a trolley and which is inclined on a, inclined through a plane, and that is inclined at an angle theta. So suppose here a trolley that is moving in downward direction, and also a simple pendulum that is mounted in it, then what will be the time period of simple pendulum in this case? So as you know that here the gravity that will affect the it will has the component that will be effective, that is g cos theta, clear? So if in case of inclination, as you know that the component of gravity that will be in downward direction, that will be affectable, that is g cos theta. So here if we put t is equal to 2 pi under root l upon g cos theta, then this will provide us the time period of any simple pendulum which is mounted on a trolley which is inclined through plane theta. So it means that if you are seeing that this time period is now dependent on the third factor, that is theta. So if theta will change, then definitely the time period of the simple pendulum that is mounted on a trolley, that will also change. And rest of the factors, as you know that it depends on the length, and also it depends on the acceleration due to gravity. But besides these two factors, if the plane is inclined, then it will also depend on theta. So with increase in theta, you can understand that how the time period will change here. Next case is that suppose we have the case of free falling body. A simple pendulum is mounted on a free falling body, then what will be the time period of the simple pendulum in that case? So as you know that in free falling body, the effective acceleration due to gravity, effective acceleration, that is equal to zero, clear? So if this is equal to zero, then from the expression of the time period, that is t is equal to 2 pi root l by g, you can easily, this will be infinite. It means that if time period is infinite, it means it will take infinite time to complete one oscillation. Simple meaning is that there is no oscillation in this condition. So if a body is free falling, then simple pendulum will not oscillate that time. And the same case is that when a lift is in the case of free falling, then also there the effective acceleration due to that is zero. So in this condition also t will be infinite. So either there is free falling body or also free falling lift. In both of the cases, this time period will be infinite, and particle will or simple pendulum will not oscillate in this condition. So I think students, all these conditions which I have discussed here, that is all clear to you. You can easily understand the factors that can affect the simple pendulum, and also how can we make simple pendulum, what will be the frequency, what will be the time period, and on which factors it will depends on. Or simple knowing these factors, if you are constructing, yeah, if you are making any simple pendulum, then we will keep that things in mind that can affect it. So obviously we will choose such types of material that will be incorporative with the simple pendulum, and also so this knowledge helps us to make some products or make any instrument very easily. So that's why we always study that. So I think all the topics that I discussed here, that is clear about to you, and I think the concept of simple pendulum, that is also clear to you. So if this concept is clear to you, so let's see some more concepts that is related to simple harmonic motion. So there are actually number of other applications. Later I will discuss that applications. Before that, I just want to discuss the simple harmonic motion in different cases. So suppose first case is that if you are taking that simple harmonic motion in one dimension, and also for this we are taking suppose that a mass is attached to a spring. So this is the case of, as you know that if this, suppose that this is a rigid end and here a spring is attached to it, and with this spring a mass m that is attached to it, clear? So this, if this spring is inextensible, this spring is flexible, this spring is weightless, that and this mass is point mass, then whole of the system will perform simple harmonic motion, clear? So this is the case of if a spring follow this condition and this mass follow this condition, then obviously it will perform simple harmonic oscillation, but nearly it can perform simple harmonic oscillation. So if in this case, what will be the, if we apply a force here to displace it by some displacement x, then obviously what will be the value of force for the displacement, that is equal to m into a, because we are displacing the particle, so it will be equal to this. And obviously, as you know that if we displace the particle, it means that we are changing its configuration, we are changing its position. So particle or mass or spring, this will oppose to change in its position because they were already in a stable in equilibrium condition, and if we are changing their equilibrium, then they will oppose it due to inertia property, due to elasticity property, they will oppose it, and due to opposition they will impart a force on the force opposite to the direction of the displacement. Means if we are applying a displacement force in this direction, so there will be a restoring force developed in the body to bring it in its equilibrium position or in its original position. So that is known as restoring force. And this restoring force is directly proportional to the displacement x. As I already discussed this case, but still I am going to summarize all the cases that can be possible, like in two dimension, one dimension, or other some types of cases. So that's why I have just taken this. So in one dimensional case, as we are seeing that there is horizontal vibrations that can occur in case of a spring, and also we can calculate easily what will be the potential energy of the system, and also you can also calculate it, what will be the displacement in this. Suppose that we have applied a force F on it, and due to that application x displacement is produced in the body, clear? So if that x displacement is produced, then how can we calculate at any time t what will be the displacement in this case? So for that case we can only we have to solve this force formula. As we are seeing that this force is if suppose that the body after displacement that is in equilibrium condition, then in equilibrium means body will comes to in equilibrium when this force will be equal to this force, clear? Until this force will not be equal to this force, then equilibrium will not possible. So for equilibrium this force must be equal to this force. So we can write m d2x upon dt2, that should be equal to, if you solve this proportionality, then here we can write some force constant k, and as this direction is different, so here one sorry, actually there is no need if we are simply taking it. So if this force will be equal to this opposition force, so finally what we can write here, d2x upon dt2 plus sorry minus k by m sorry kx is equal to 0, clear? So here finally what we can write, that is minus k by m x is equal to 0, or in place of k by m you can write some angle frequency of the oscillation, that is equal to d2x upon dt2 plus minus omega 0 square x is equal to 0, clear? So this is the differential equation that is same as the simple harmonic oscillation that we have discussed before, and here omega 0, that is the angular frequency of the oscillation in the case of a spring mass system. So what is the angular frequency in this case? That is equal to you can write omega 0 or omega. Suppose that you want to write it, then no problem. So this is equal to root k by m, clear? And with the help of this, we can easily calculate what will be the frequency of the oscillation in case of a spring mass system attached to it. So as you know that angular frequency is equal to 2 pi into frequency of the oscillation. So we can all calculate what will be the frequency of the oscillation here. So that is equal to this factor. Means if the spring constant will change, means if we take different spring, then there will be different oscillations produced in the body. And also if we take different masses attached here, then obviously due to that masses frequency will change. Now let's see what will be the time period in the case of a spring mass system. So as you know that time period is reciprocal of frequency. So simply time period is 1 by nu, that is 2 pi root m by k. So time period of the oscillation, that also depends on two factors, that is m and k. So what is m? That is mass of the body attached to the system. Means greater will be the mass of the body, greater will be the oscillation performed. Greater will be the time period of the oscillation. Means it will take greater time to complete one oscillation when its mass is greater. And also if force constant is greater, then in that case time period will be small. Means in a small time it will complete a oscillation. So if we have a purpose that suppose that we want to get some small time period, then what to do in that case? For to get a small time period, m should be small, k should be large. Clear? So if we choose some spring of force constant greater and some mass of smaller, then in that case we can easily we can have this time period that will be smaller. Clear? So I think in a spring mass system, what is the time period and on what which factors it depends on, that is clear to you. It simply depends on mass of the body attached to it and force constant, means the which types of spring we are uses to it. So those two factors it will depend. If any one will be changed, then definitely its value of time period will change. So it depends on these two factors. So I think the case of one-dimensional spring, that is clear to you. So if this is and also we have taken the case of horizontal spring, so I think that case is clear. So rest of the cases, such types of cases, we will discuss in next class. So I think today what I have discussed, all the things are clear to you. So let's end the class here. In next classes, we will discuss next things. Thank you guys.